Hello. There is no reason to panic. I'm not here to talk about Justin Bieber. I'm not here to talk about Radiohead as well, but you ought to know that neither of these artists' sounds would have been the same without synthesizers. Now, synthesizers are amazing because they take this and turn it into this. And how they're able to achieve this effect is by taking electricity, turning it into sound, and morphing that sound so it becomes music. Way back when, this is what synths looked like. They were huge, complex, and you practically had to be a genius to get even a simple sound out of one. Over time, they became smaller, sleeker, more affordable, and as most things, found their way onto computers. Which was awesome for me, because I grew up in a place where I didn't have access to hardware synthesizers. But when I tried to explore synthesizers, I was confronted with interfaces that looked like this. And I had no idea where to even begin figuring these things out. And the fact remains that synths are amazing expressive tools, but it's this very expressive nature that makes them so complicated. And they provide no entry point for beginners. In order to address this, I created an interactive website called Signal Flow. Signal Flow is based on three key problems that surfaced during my research. The first is that of cognitive overload. Synths throw every single parameters at you when you open them up. And as a beginner, it's not the best feeling to have 45 knobs staring at you in the face. I wanted to simplify synths down to their most essential components and introduce them one by one so the user knows exactly what's happening as sound travels from one component to the other. I'm going to take you through what this experience looks and sounds like, but be warned that this contains unshaped sounds, which might be a little jarring. So you start with a power switch, and you get your first component. You can add new elements to the circuit just to see how the sound is shaped as it moves from one component to the other. And you can add modulators to see how this sound can be shaped over time. While this was a great way to get people comfortable with synths, I realized that there was really no understanding as to what was happening under the hood. And the problem is that in order to figure this out, people have to refer to synth tutorials that are focused on replicating a specific sound. And they have to navigate away from their synths, absorb knowledge, and come back to them. And this process is full of friction. So people become more interested in trying to follow the instructions of the tutorial than experimenting and making new discoveries. In this realm, theory and practice seem to be two different things. And I wanted to see what happens if you combine them. So I added a feature where I'm able to open up each component and see how it actually works by reading a bit about each control. And then you can close it and go back to jamming. And finally, there are a lot of learning tools that teach you how to use complex systems. But while they're really good at sorting out the fundamentals, they don't really take into account the context in which you're actually going to be working. And I wanted to see if I could bridge the gap between my product and pro audio software. So I added a feature where you could see how each parameter looks like in the most common commercial synths found out there. Signal Flow was an exercise in understanding complexity by reducing it to its most simple components. After all, what is complexity if not simple things piling up? But the thing that really kept me going was moments like this. This is what happened after one of my synth sessions, where I got a room full of five people who knew nothing about synthesizers and gave them just enough knowledge to start putting it together in unexpected ways. And they weren't replicating anyone else's song. They weren't doing covers. They were making their own original music, which was so exciting. And I realized that what giving people the knowledge to experiment does is frees them up to combine it in ways that make sense to them. And what you end up with is really unique combinations of things that no one else could have thought of. And I believe this pattern holds for the future of education, which is not around creating lists of actions for people to follow, but giving them just enough knowledge to experiment and creating space where they can put this knowledge together in unexpected ways. Thank you.